Brian, and I represent one of the Musketeers in Sir Francis Drake's raiding party.
Okay, and you guys are planning what today then?
Well, this evening we'll be reenacting the fight for the town of St. Augustine, when in 1586 Sir Francis Drake and more than 2,000 men kind of culminated their tour of raiding their way through Spanish colonial towns, finishing with St. Augustine.
Yeah, now I see you got these things around your neck.
Yes, this is called a bandolier. Goes by a lot of names. That's one of the more common ones. Is a very typical way of carrying ammunition for a firearm in this time period. Many of Drake's soldiers would have been carrying matchlock calibers or arquebuses like this, which actually would have been a fairly light firearm for the time period. And while you could carry all of your gunpowder in a single flask, which would necessitate measuring each shot before pouring it down the barrel, the bandolier was also very popular because it avoided that measuring process. I've just been working on measuring gunpowder into each of my charges. A little wooden bottle, in this case wooden, very often made of metal, carrying a single charge of gunpowder, measured out ahead of time so that you can do that rapidly without having to stop and worry about measuring on the battlefield.
All right.
Now the charger would specifically carry the gunpowder to be poured down the barrel. You've got a separate powder flask, a priming flask, to load powder into the pan at the rear of the weapon, and the bullets would be carried separately in the pouch.
Okay.
So all three components carried separately.
Well, I wish you luck on that raid. Hope the Spaniards don't give you a hard time.
Well, thanks very much.
Thank you, Brian.
Sure thing.